Good morning, children. We are again here to explain the further chapter. Now, earlier we had seen that food is necessary for growth and maintenance. We obtain food from plant parts and animals. We use different parts of plant as food. For example, plant. This plant provides us different kinds of edible that may be in the form of fruit, flowers, leaves, seed, etc. Also, the animals provide us different things to eat. Now, plant of the parts that we use as food. First one is root. So, roots are some of the roots of the plant are also used as food, such as sweet potato, carrot, radish, beetroot, turnip. Do you like these? Yes, I know. So, we use roots of this plant as fruit. Flowers look beautiful. We use some flowers of the plant as food. For example, rose petal jam. You might not have heard rose petal jam, but gulkan. Yes, we eat in palm. So, this gulkan is also a flower of the plant and we use them as food. We use flower of cauliflower, jasmine, sunflower as food. Children, do you like all kinds of food? Some fruits are sour and some are sweet. They are also used as food. Apple, banana, watermelon, guava, mango, grapes. These fruits are used as food. Now comes seeds. How can we forget seeds? They are the very important part of our food. Most of the seeds are in the form of food grains. They are wheat, rice, maize, jowar, and also some of the seeds of soybean, groundnut, mustard. They are used to yield oil, edible oil. Now, sprouts are also a part of food. These sprouts are obtained from seeds. Take a big mouth vessel, fill it with water and soak the seeds in it. The seeds get swollen next day. Keep it for a day so it gets swollen. Now, the second day, put these seeds on a wet cloth and cover it tightly. So, when these seeds get warm, they get sprouted third day. So, these seeds, raw seeds, they give more nutrition than the raw seeds. So, they are more nutritious. These sprouted seeds can be eaten raw. Now, we get food from animals also. So, cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, they yield milk, and from milk we get various dairy products such as cheese, curd, paneer, much more than this. So, animal also provides us a very important part of our food. Another food that is egg. Eggs are obtained from chicken, duck and turkey. These animals give egg. Meat is obtained from goat, sheep and chicken. Also some of the human beings and some of the people eat seafood such as fish, prawn, crab, etc. as their food. Also, we obtain honey from the honey bees. Can we forget honey as a food? No, because it's a mouth watering food. So this honey is collected by bees. Bees suck the nectar or the sweet juice of the flower and collect it into their living place called beehives. From beehives we get honey. You all might have seen beehives hanging on the tree. Don't disturb these bees, otherwise it may bite you, and their bite is very dangerous. Now we will see types of animal based on food habit. Do all living organisms feed on plant for their food? I know all organisms need food, but dear children, they don't depend only on plants for their food. Different animals have different food habit. Based on their food habits, we can classify them as herbivores, omnivores, and carnivores. So, herbivores can be classified as plant eater animals. Herbs means plant and vores means eater. Some of the examples of herbivores are goat, cow, horse, deer, giraffe, butterfly, etc. Now these herbivorous animals have flat and broad teeth. They chew the food with the help of these flat and broad teeth. These flat and broad teeth helps them to hold the plant and grind the plant parts and fill their stomach. These animals, what do they do? Do you know that? They eat all the food together at the same time. They fill their stomach. And when they are relaxed, they bring the food back into their mouth and chew the food again. So, the process of chewing the food by bringing it into the mouth from the stomach is called rumination, and such animals are called ruminant. Now here herbivores birds are also there. Butterfly, then hummingbird, they have a straw-like shape and they suck the nectar from the flowers. Now we will see another group of animals that depend on meat. For example, carn. Carn means meat and vores means eater. Those animals which feed only on meat are called carnivores. The animals which obtain their food only from other animals in the form of meat, so they are called carnivores. The examples of carnivores are lion, tiger, fox, eagle, snake, spider, shark. All these animals depend on other animals for their food. Now, these carnivores animals have strong jaws. Why do they need strong jaws? Because they need to tear the flesh and crush the bones of the other animal. So, the teeth of the carnivores are sharp and pointed. And they have sharp claws also. They chew the meat with their strong back teeth. back teeth they used to chew the flesh and the bones. So these animals can adapt, eat meat easily because of the adaptation in teeth. Also, there are certain carnivorous birds such as eagle, chameleon. This eagle has curved pointed beak so that it can tear the flesh of the other animals, while chameleon has a very long teeth to hold the insect firmly. Now comes the third group, that is omnivorous. Omni means all types of food they eat, and vorous means eater. So a man eats both plant product as well as the animal product, so they are called omnivores. Example can be given as human, bear, crow, chicken, lizard, rat. These animals eat both plant product as well as the animal product. So depending on the food habits, their teeth are incisor, that is cutting teeth, canine, tearing teeth, premolar and molars to grind the food. As the food habits are there, they all have different kind of teeth that can be helped to eat flesh and plant parts. Now, omnivorous birds have sharp and pointed beak for eating both plant as well as small insect. The examples are crow, chicken, sparrow. They feed on both plant as well as insect by using their sharp and pointed beak. So, up till now we have seen herbivores, omnivores and carnivores. Depending on the food habits, we have categorized them. Besides this, we have other animals such as parasites, scavengers and decomposers. Each and every one depends on different kind of food for their nutrition. Now, parasites. Parasites, they live in or other animals and obtain their nutrients. These parasites live inside or they feed on the other bodies for their food. They can be inside the body also, such as fleas, bacteria, virus, tapeworm, plasmodium, etc. So these animals, they feed on other animals, but they harm them also. Now comes scavengers. These scavengers, they depend on dead animals or plants, such as vulture. So scavengers are also called cleaner of the nature because they eat away the dead and decaying animals, plant also. And important role of decomposer. Can you tell me what is decomposer? Decompose. Decomposer means to break down. So these decomposer, they depend, for example, such as bacteria, they decompose the dead plant and animals part also, and they convert complex organic material of dead plant or parts of the dead animal into simple nutrient such as iron, nitrogen. These iron and nitrogen, they get into the soil. And when they get into the soil, they are made available to the new growing plant. So children, we have seen that all the organisms need food. The source of food are plant and animal. We have seen different type of animal depending upon the food habits of their daily life. And